Fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. Today I wanted to talk about a Vulkel racket. So this is the Vulkel V-Cell 10. This interesting head shape, similar to a Pacific racket or a Fisher, old Fisher vacuum it looks like. So this tells me something straight away. When you see this head shape, is that its sweet spot will not be a very big. This is going to be a pretty small sweet spot, might be a very sweet spot. Then when you hit it, you feel like a nice sensation, or you feel really in control when you hit the sweet spot. But overall, you see that towards the edges, there's not a lot of room for errors. I think that's one of the key things. It almost looks like it's a 95 square inch racket, not so much a 98. Sometimes the sweet spot becomes more like this than towards these areas, so you have a bit of more forgiveness to hit higher in the hoop. But overall, anything towards the edges of the frame, which is where most people miss hit, is gonna be a little bit of a problem. So that's one issue I can see with this racket. I thought I would pretty much hate the racket. I had a feeling, because I knew it was a pretty stiff racket. The stiffness rating is 69 strong according to Tennis Warehouse. I can't measure stiffness, but I do trust their ratings because it's on an average. So 69 strong means it's 72 unstrung. Very stiff racket. And if we look at the other specs of this frame, it is a 98 square inch frame, 1619 pattern, 300 grams, and the weight needs to be more towards the head. So it's 32.5 centimeter balance, which means you put around 33.5 centimeter balance with strings around 2 points head light it went strung. So, but overall, I actually really enjoyed playing with it, especially felt super nice on the one-handed backhand. Felt like I actually gravitated more towards this than many other frames I had around during this this trip. And it is quite stiff. That would be my concern for many players with tennis elbow. I play with it pretty much all day yesterday, and I feel nothing in my arm, and I usually always feel something the day after. But still, I would be a bit careful with the stiffness rating. Other Tennis Warehouse playtesters all talked about stiffness, so be mindful. If you have no issues with stiffer frames and you want kind of a controlled oriented frame that feels pretty whippy, I think this one is interesting. It feels pretty similar to the IGA Svantec signature model from Technifiber. I feel like I can switch between those two frames without any kind of adjustment, really. Good one-handed backhand rackets, really whippy on that wing for me. Good stiffness for power. I would definitely bump up the swing weight if you get it in the low 310, 315. To get it around 320, 25 at least. I think that's close to perfect. It does feel like it's a little bit heavier than the average rating. But overall, I really enjoyed it. Decent on serves, felt really connected to the frame, could hit both one-handed backhand and some good forehands with it. I don't know. Sometimes I feel like it's the racket surprised me, and this one did. I'm not gonna switch to this racket. I'm too worried about the stiffness over time, because if I see a racket with nearing 70, and it's a little bit the same with the IGA, they really play amazingly well in many ways, but the stiffness is there. You do feel it at times, and especially if you hit a lot of off-center shots, then you shouldn't play with these frames. But when you're playing well, you're usually fine, you don't feel anything. But yeah, over time there's a risk that the stiffness will build up to some arm issues, and I'm always trying to be a little bit careful with these types of frames. So interesting frame, small sweet spot, but some nice control when you're playing well. It does actually give you a little bit of an injection of pace as well. Felt like I could generate pace on serves, forehands, and on backhands when needed. And it, for me, it felt very natural. But I think this is one of those rackets that you either love or hate. I did give it to a few other players. Katrin hit with you with this from Tennis Warehouse. Henrik tried it, and they actually both also liked it. So I'm a little bit surprised by that. I thought it was more of a polarizing frame, but it's definitely worth giving a demo if you like. If you have a one-handed backhand, you like a little bit of extra stiffness for more power, or you just prefer a kind of stiffer, crisper, boardier feel, This is not like a board, but it is relatively stiff. And I do enjoy that feel, but my arm usually doesn't. So that's why I don't play with these stiffer rackets, you know, longer than for usually the review period, because then I'm just worried that some arm issues might pop up. But playing all day yesterday, pretty much with this one, and I played the day before as well, and I didn't really feel anything, but, you know, 10 sessions down the line, I might feel something, so I will keep you posted. But worth a demo. It's not a racket you just go out and buy blindly, maybe. But if you like the IGA style racket, if you want a stiffer racket, but still 98 square inches, that is a little bit whippy, I think this one is fun. It definitely looks quite fun, and it did actually play really well, surprisingly. So interesting frame, weird head shape, but it does feel like you really get through the air with it pretty nicely. So definitely worth checking out the Völkl Wiesel 10-300 if this is the type of frame and specs that suit you. Any kind of arm issues, I would probably stay away because of the stiffness being too high. And you might need to bump up the weight if you get a really low swing weight on it. So it's not a huge thumbs up, but it's something that surprised me, and it's actually more interesting than I thought. So I hope to review more and try more Völkl rackets. I haven't really been able to get a hold of them. There are not many demos, but now I got this demo from Tennis Warehouse, so I'm gonna play with it more and then ship it back. We'll see how it plays. And I'll update this review if something changes in my opinion about this frame. But I think I'm pretty much dialed into what this racket does and doesn't do. So I hope you found this Wiesel 10 racket review useful. I haven't done any Völkl, like I said, in a long time, so I thought it was time to do it now that I got the chance. And if you have any questions, put them in the comments below. I'll try to deal with them in Q&A, where I sometimes also have time to reply on in the comments below. If you really want to increase your chances of getting answers to your question by subscribing to the channel, then you get a little of a subscribe icon next to your name when you write a comment, and that's I'll try to prioritize those because I really appreciate you subscribers. It doesn't cost anything to subscribe, and it really helps the channel. So subscribe and like if you like the stuff I do. Really appreciate it. If you also want to support Tennis Nerd in other ways, you can check out the Tennis Warehouse Europe and Tennis Warehouse and Tennis Only links in the description below. If you buy anything through the affiliates in the description, I get a small commission at no cost to you. And if you want to support Tennis Nerd and get more content, you join patreon.com/tennisnerd. That is all for now. Have a nice day, and don't forget to play some tennis. Nicht.